We made it. The end of national final season is finally here. But before we begin, if you are new here, please subscribe. Make videos about all things Eurovision that you'll love. And I'm also on Patreon, where I'm just about to upload some outtakes from my Eurovision reviews. So if you want to see those and support me in the process, go to patreon.com/MrSirTwo. So yes, indeed, there were 25 different Eurovision national finals this year. And of those, I followed along with 10. I've already reviewed 6 of those. There were 4 others that I just didn't have time to make videos about. So consider this a little bit of a wrap-up of ones you might have missed. And we shall go in chronological order, starting with one of the first, January 30th, and ESCZ.
Good evening, Europe, and good morning, Australia. It is truly an honor to welcome you all to the ESCZ National Selection.
I was quite hyped for this one. Dommy were one of my faves last year, and this was the first live Czech national final in 15 years. But honestly, it was a bit of a letdown. There was no crowd, the host kind of came across as awkward, and the production was pretty bare bones. And it was all done in English, too. It was almost like they misunderstood what the word national in national final meant.
Please welcome the first contestant, Myla.
That being said, though, the quality of the 5 songs on offer was pretty decent. My favourite of which having to be Rodan. Love going to parties, just trying to meet somebody. Now everybody wants me, but nobody likes me. Yeah, beautiful bodies dancing all upon me. Introvert Party Club was just so much fun, wasn't it? It was this quirky little tune that reminded me so much of the sort of music your favourite YouTubers were making back in 2011. It had a really retro internet vibe to it. And the lyrics were painfully relatable too. I felt very seen for those 3 minutes. Wasting my life chasing good times. But of course, our winners were in fact Vesna. She is her own queen, and she will do it. You can take your hands back. No one wants my voice dead. We are not your dogs, we are not your dogs. They ooze stage presence and charisma. You can just tell they absolutely love performing together. And the message is so important too. It's about gender inequality and sisterhood, and the lyrics are in 4 different languages. It's a real story of togetherness and embracing difference. And I really, really hope this one does well in May. Next to February 11th and Denmark's Melody Grand Prix. This was my first time watching. I went into it kind of understanding the quality to be 1 or 2 good songs and the rest kind of being a bit sh**. But actually, I was pleasantly surprised. The quality of those 8 acts was pretty good. One of my favourites having to be Maya Maya, if only because it would have been hilarious to see how they would have censored that one in Liverpool. I can taste the light on the tip of your tongue. I love your beautiful bullshit. And I'll fall for it every time. But it was a great tune too. Sure, maybe it wasn't the most up-to-date sound, but I was just in love with her sass and her energy. I love me a female powerhouse pop bop. I can taste the light on the tip of my tongue. And of course, our winner was Riley. And I absolutely adore this one. It's in my top 10 quite comfortably. Lose, It sounds like it's been taken straight off of Danish radio, like it's fresh from the charts. It's got a real contemporary, really popular sound to it that Denmark don't always send. And he performs it brilliantly too. His vocals are amazing and that performance is really, really slick. I think a lot of people are sleeping on this one. Next to February 26th and Poland's absolute mouthful of a selection show. The heart of Europe beats here, we choose a hit for Eurovision. And I haven't seen the Polish show either, but of course we all know how much they struggle in the adult contest, so I was kind of curious to see how this one panned out.
Dobry wieczór Państwu! Witamy z Warszawy, gdzie właśnie tu i teraz
bije serce Europy!
And much like some of the other selections this year, it just reminded me of the UK You Decide days. You could tell there were some really passionate people behind the scenes. The amount of different interacts they had alone told you that much. But at the same time, when you looked at that selection of songs, you could tell that they didn't really get Eurovision either. And of those 10 acts, the only worthy winner was Jan. This was hands down the strongest and most unique performance of the night. It was this dark, electro-y type tune, and he oozed sex and charisma. It was such a full-on 3 minutes. And it is a real disappointment that he wasn't picked for Liverpool. Show us some good entertainment. Victory is your only payment. Gladiator. Ah! Instead, they chose Blanka. And all the controversy aside, this was just one big letdown. The song is frankly dreadful. It's a cheap little pop tune that just doesn't stand out. And her vocals are so ropey to boot that it just loses any credibility. It just feels like one big wasted opportunity picking this one. And last but not least, my 10th selection, Iceland's Söngvakeppnin.
Góðakvöldið, úrslit Söngvakeppninar 2023 eru farin af stað og hér farmiðin til Liverpool.
I just adored this show, as ever. There's just such a different vibe to this one. They take things a little bit slower and you can tell they absolutely love every second of it. It is just such a joy to follow along. And come the final on March 4th, we had 5 songs in the running. And my faves of the night just had to be Celebs. I mean, where else can you do something as wacky as this than at Eurovision? It's so ridiculously, wonderfully over the top. It is everything that I love about Iceland at Eurovision, and then some. Move your feet to the beat of impending doom. Dance until it drops. Dance till your heart stops. Our winner, though, was of course Dilia. And much like the rest of the Nordics this year, Power is a proper little Scandi pop bop. It's almost got a bit of a Robin vibe. That super catchy late noughties, early 2010s electropop kind of sound that was very much the soundtrack of my youth. She performs it with so much passion and conviction. It's just her up on that stage, but she absolutely owns every single second. It is a really, really solid 3 minute number. And that, as they say, is that. National final season is done for another year. What about you, humble viewer? Did you see Czechia, Denmark, Poland, or Iceland's selection shows? Who were your faves of the bunch? Let me know down below in the comments. And please leave a like and subscribe for more. Eurovision's only 7 weeks away now, and I've got loads of videos planned to keep you entertained until then, including, of course, my top picks for Liverpool. So make sure you stick around for more. And to keep watching, click the links on screen now.